Buddy, this is DotP back with another Magic Mondays. It's going to be a quicker than normal stream tonight because instead of doing a Magic Online draft, we're going to take a look at Duels of the Planeswalkers. In particular, going to be looking forward to cracking my first sealed packs in the sealed deck campaign. That should be cool. I've played quite a bit of Duels already, almost all the way through the single-player campaign. Be getting in-game in a second here. The way the sealed deck works is, I guess, there are two slots where you will have a certain number of packs to open up with random cards, and you build your deck out of those, and you've got both a single-player campaign and a multiplayer campaign that you play with those cards. So that should be quite a bit of fun to see what we get and see if I can't make the best of it. Let's see here. Alrighty. So let's make sure that I've got everything set up. I normally have been playing this with the music off, but we can turn that back on for the stream. I got Chandra there. Alright, let's start with sealed play. Alright, as we play, we unlock more booster packs of Magic 2014. We're going to disable the tutorial. Yes, I'm sure we want to skip. So we're going to choose one of these boosters. Let's choose a Garrick booster. Okay, so we've got our rare is a Nightmare. Got the Green Staff. Got a Tormented Soul. Marauding Malhorn. Oaken Form. Murder. Some good removal. If I were drafting this pack, I'd be pretty happy. Let's see. Got another murder. Got a pacifism. Acidic slime. A little land destruction. I'm feeling a little bit of maybe black-green going on. Might evokes another oaken form. Garrick's pack leader. Shock. What we got here? Disorient. Prized unicorn. Giant Scorpion, Death Touch. Pretty cool. Alright, opening booster number 3. Fog. Our rare is Aegis Angel. Got another murder. Got an Assassinate. Staff of the Sun Magus. Yavimaya Worm. Fog. Sign and Blood. Cool. Hunt the Weak, Briar Pack Alpha. Yeah, I am liking the black and the green so far. Be on the lookout for any splash colors. Our rare in this one is Redirect, which... Okay, I mean, that's not terrible. Some more black removal, Minotaur Abomination, which isn't so good. But oh, what do we have here? Vampire Nighthawk, one of my favorite cards. Death Touch. I got a War Priest of Thune, maybe worth a splash. Alright, another black rare, Runescarred Demon. I hadn't actually seen this one before. When Runescarred Demon enters battlefield, search your library for a card, put it into your hand, and then shuffle your library. So it's a 6/6 flying with a Demonic Tutor attached for 5 and double black. Ravenous Rats, another Yavimaya Worm. Prize Unicorn's got a lure built in. Giant Growth's always good. We've got a Leonin Scimitar and another Oaken Form, another Deadly Recluse. I mean, unless I'm missing something, it looks like our best cards have consistently been green and black. Even more murders. Door to Nothingness. I've actually got a deck that plays this, but Terramorphic Expanse, a little bit of mana fixing, and nothing great in this pack. Another Deadly Red, Clues, Rumbling, Baloth, I guess a 4-4 for 4 is not too bad. Bloodhunter Bat, 2-2 Flying for 4, with a Life Drain attached, and Phyrexian Hulk. Alright, so we're going to want to build a deck here. Look at our black cards. Tormented Souls at the bottom of our curve. I guess we could put in Ravenous Rats for now. We're absolutely playing the Vampire Nighthawk. We'll come back to that removal. I kind of like Assassinate. I got a bunch of double black spells here, so it might already be worth playing ten sources to power up our nightmare. Yeah, let's add the murders for now. And the Bloodhunter Bat. 11 cards in the deck so far. Let's see. We absolutely want an Acidic Slime. That's pretty much a Windmill Slam there if we were drafting. Got a bunch of enchantments. I don't care about the Sliver. Deadly Recluse, a little bit more. Reach, Rumbling Baloth, absolutely. That's not what I thought it was going to do. See, we're going to put the Terramorphic Expanse in there for a little bit of fixing. See, is there anything in white that we might consider for a splash? We've got 17 cards in the deck so far. We've got 1, 2... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 creatures so far. I'd like to play about 7 more. We've got 4 murders, 5. We've pretty much got our spells. We can throw the giant scorpion in. At this point, it's almost any creature. Yeah, almost any. We will throw the brindle boar in, and the deadly recluse. Not looking to play the sliver. Play the briar pack alpha. Deck strength has gone up to average. With double black, I think I'm going to want to play 18 lands, so maybe just one more creature. A little card advantage maybe from Garrick's pack leader. That's power 3 or greater. We've got a few things that can power that up. if we go to adjust lands manually. Well, we already have a Terramorphic Expanse, so we could probably get one more card in here. This sealed pool actually looks pretty cool. I know some people already burned through their two sealed pools for free, and are a little mad that they got to pay $2 for an extra round. I think what they don't understand is the same decks are able to be played in multiplayer, and if you could just infinitely refresh your sealed pool without any cost whatsoever, people would just do so until they had just a ridiculous deck. But I'm pretty happy with this as somewhat playable, although, man, four murders. Let's see, we got 12, 10. Let's see what my low-cost spells are. Definitely going to want quite a bit of black fixing. If I'm going to play Terramorphic Expanse, I want to add 17 lands, probably go like 8 and 9, because it's not like I've got dual lands here. Swamps and 8 forests. That's 17 plus the Terramorphic Expanse. Curious what it'll tell me to do. It said 10-7. Fair enough. Safe changes. Deck strength is awesome. I like that. Let's get ourselves a cool looking deck box here. That's a good looking deck box for this. Yeah, we'll go with that one. Okay, that was not what I meant to do. Alright, green-black sealed deck. We're going to be really creative here. Alright, we've got our deck built. Alt-tab real quick to make sure that things are going well in the chat. And then I'll do at least the first match in the campaign, and next Monday might even take this into multiplayer.
What are you doing? They're going to see you!
Yes, what am I doing? They are going to see me. I don't have the laptop up right now, so I'm gonna pop into chat real quick. Hello to the real Garen. Let's see what we can make out of this seal deck against Ajani Goldmane. Versus a Johnny sealed deck. Alright. This is fun. I like this first look. Alright. We have our big bomb here. And it looks like they give you a free mulligan, which, without green mana, I think we are going to take. That seems pretty good. Got some removal in the Terramorphic Expanse. Start with the swamp, though. We can use our prime removal against whatever comes up. Vigilant Sliver. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're getting a forest anytime soon. Is this a single color deck? Well, it's a Johnny, I suppose that makes sense. No blocks. But I think that Sliver is going to... Oh, Sliver cannot get assassinated. Sliver's just going to have to get murdered. Make sure that nothing worse comes out. Not that I think the AI is going to be dumb enough to cast something else pre-combat, but... So, Mono White Sliver, stop timer. We're going to murder one of them. Not a sliver. Okay, so we can play a forest and a death toucher. And a tormented soul. Actually get some offense going here. I'm not sure how the AI is going to react. Fiend Hunter. Ew. Can't get rid of my Death Toucher, are we? I don't approve of that at all. There will be no blocking, but there will be some murder. It'd be nice if I could play both my removal spells at once. But that is not to be. Oh, don't show me that again. Let's assassinate him. And we will attack. He can't block anyway. We'll get our Death Touch guy back with a murder next, unless he plays like something even bombier than Fiend Hunter. For a deck with strength, awesome. I'm not doing so hot so far. Alright, I'm at 9, he's at 19. Play the Blood Hunter bat, but I cannot. Attack with all. Continue. Alright, we'll see if we've stabilized here, because we're going to gain a little bit of life off of that Blood Hunter bat in a second. I am not afraid of an ox. Happily trade for his sliver if he chooses to attack, which he does not. Play an evasive creature. I will choose a player to lose 2 life. And we'll attack here with the unblockable guy. It's looking like things are turning around. We could survive to the late game and draw something a little bomby. Destroy target enchantments. Well, I got news for you, buddy. Safe passage, eh? Skip blocking, since we can't trade. Interesting. Man. We're gonna continue. I don't think it is time to sign in blood. We will attack with these two. Nope, not gonna put myself so low by signing in blood. He's got 2 cards in hand. We will block the Vigilance dude and take 4. +2/+2 when game's flying, okay. Oh, okay. Jump over and put me at 1. That's probably gonna get him there. I don't think I can kill him this turn. Although that helps. Expanse. Man, I'd love to sign in blood. I'm glad I didn't do it last turn, though. We'll grab another swamp, just in case we live long enough to see a vampire. Or a nightmare, rather. Continue. We'll attack with the one guy who can't block anyway. Because we don't feel like killing ourselves with our last spell. I'm feeling pretty good about this deck, even if I lose this match. And unlike normal Magic Mondays, when I... Okay, let's see. Ooh, that's nice. So we're going to give our Vampire Nighthawk +2/+2. We will continue. And then swing like that, gain 4, and hit in for 5. Much as I like the idea of signing in blood, it seems a little suicide-y. Block like that. Not ready to trade. I'm not sure what your plan is, sir. Suntail Hawk's a pretty good plan. You're a little late to the party, aren't you? We if I swing all out. Yeah, this is not as much fun to cast as it normally would be, but I guess we'll destroy a land. Got a combat phase. We'll attack like that. Never liked the idea of a chump block for an acidic slime, but at the moment that's all he can really do for me. Continue. We're not going to hurt ourselves with Sun and Blood. Looks like we may have stabilized at one life. Oh, I smell a trick. Sack it for 4 life. And I think we just swing out and win. Boom, boom, boom. Attack. So, looks like we just stabilized at 1, because I don't see any blocks coming, I don't see any fast effects. Boom! Sealed the deal! Got that achievement! Ooh, and we get a new booster pack unlocked. So I'm not sure what... So we can go back... And... We've got... back... What do we do here to... Edit your sealed deck? Got a new booster pack to unwrap. That's pretty sweet. Mark of the Vampire, +2/+2 in lifelink. Windstorm. X damage to each creature with flying. Another Assassinate. That's a little easier to cast than Murder. I might actually want to put that in. Our rare is a Gin of Wishes. And we got a Fog. I don't like Fog. So cool, that was our reward for defeating Ajani. We have a 75 card pool for this deck. So, I'm looking forward to doing it. Next week I will probably take one last swing at Modern Masters on Modo before returning back to some sealed play here. Just because if I don't play next week, I'm not going to be able to. But yeah, I'd like to thank people for tuning in this evening. The highlights will for sure be tuning up on YouTube tonight. So if you hadn't gotten Duels of the Planeswalkers yet, got a little bit of a preview of what the sealed feature looks like. I can see myself actually buying 5 packs of additional sealed slots for this. It's certainly cheaper to get a little bit more limited play experience against other human players than playing Magic Online. They don't really keep any of the value there.
I won't ask you to be faithful.
Glad you had fun there, the real Garen. The rules of Magic are fairly complex, but I think that Duels is actually, especially for $10, a good introduction to the game. I play with the paper card fairly regularly and somewhat competitively, and then every Monday, tune in to run a stream of something Magic-related online. As I can throughout the week, I do other streams. Been doing a lot of blind playthroughs of MMOs Rift and The Secret World, so you can tune back in for that. Thanks for tuning in, and until next time, I'll talk to everybody later.